Hey guys, Matt Daigle here. We're talking all about warm blankets today, but not the type of blanket you're probably thinking about. We're talking blankets for your house. That's right, it's all about insulation today, and specifically all about mineral wool batt insulation. We're gonna give you the full lowdown on this type of insulation and what you should know before buying. And also whether it gets a pass or a fail as a sustainable building material. Now before we dive in, hit that subscribe button to see more videos just like this one. Now without further ado, let's dig in. So mineral wool batt insulation was designed to be installed in wall cavities, floors, ceilings, and even attic spaces. You know, the first thing people usually look for with insulation is the R value per inch. Now the R value is essentially the ability for something to resist heat flow. So the higher the R value per inch, the better. So a home with a higher R value in its walls, basement and attic, will make sure it stays nice and warm in winter and nice and cool in the summer. And as far as batts go, which is the format that this material comes in, mineral wool gets high praises because, well, it achieves close to an R4 per inch, which is comparable to other high-performing insulations. That means for a typical 2x6 framed wall, you'll achieve an R value of 22, and that's with the insulation alone. Mineral wool also resists pests, fire, and moisture. Very few insulation materials have all these benefits wrapped into one package. But what is mineral wool exactly? Mineral wool insulation is made from spinning slag, which is a waste product in the production of steel. It can also be made from natural rock or a combination of molten slag and natural rock, and even glass. Now, typically, mineral wool stone insulation is made from 90% recycled content. Now, one of the historical pitfalls to mineral wool batts has been that it typically has a binder to hold all these fibers together. And these chemical binders have historically been made of VOCs, like formaldehyde, which means the insulation would off-gas these chemicals, which ends up being dangerous for anyone installing the product, and also having an impact on the indoor air quality for the homeowners. Now, in recent years, VOCs, or volatile organic compounds, are less of a concern since there's been a general move to using low or no VOC binders, which mitigates those pitfalls. But they're still around, so you've got to pay attention when you're picking your mineral wool. And one way to know for sure that you're getting a mineral wool batt that has low or no VOCs is by looking for the Green Guard standard, or an equally rigorous emission standard, right on the packaging. Owens Corning and Rockwool are the two more recognizable brands on the market in this category, and both have a newer low VOC version that is Green Guard Gold certified, so just be sure to check the packaging before buying. Mineral wool typically has a higher density than common fiberglass insulation, so it also has better sound blocking properties. Now, other alternatives to these types of batts are cotton, cellulose, and sheep's wool. Generally speaking, though, mineral wool batts are priced over fiberglass at about $1.50 to $1.70 per square foot based on an R22 batt, and they're also priced under more natural alternatives like sheep's wool. Now, one thing I do want to talk about is the production of mineral wool. At its core, mineral wool typically takes waste from other sectors such as steel and glass, using as much as 90% recycled content to create, and transforms that waste into something really useful. The most notable part of the manufacturing process, though, is the combustion necessary to melt all these waste products so that they can be spun into wool, as well as the addition of chemical binders. So while mineral wool has a good amount of embodied energy in it to be created during the manufacturing process, it's actually much lower than other forms of insulation. It's about half of fiberglass and 1/5 of polyiso and EPS as far as embodied energy used to create it. But it is still much higher than more natural alternatives like cellulose, which is just 1/5 the embodied energy of mineral wool. Wool and hemp batts would also score much higher on the low embodied energy scale. It should also be worth noting that because of its compressibility, mineral wool batts are super transportable, as they can be compressed to about 1/9 of their uncompressed size. And we can't forget insulation's purpose in the first place, to address comfort and minimize the heating and cooling requirements for our homes. On the waste side, packaging is usually minimal with just recyclable plastic covering, and any additional waste would be from offcuts of the batts themselves. And since it resists moisture, fire, and insects, you can expect mineral wool to have a long lifespan. Lastly, on the health side, mineral batts are also impervious to moisture, which means you don't need to worry about mold or mildew or necessarily throwing out the insulation in the event that it does get wet. Perhaps the greatest health implications are present during installation, and even though formaldehyde may be excluded from these newer versions, it's still a good idea to wear proper eyewear, masks, and gloves during the installation process. So back to our original question of whether this building material gets a pass or fail on the sustainability side, from us at Rise, it gets a pass. And this is a good thing, as it is one of the most widely available insulation materials out there, perhaps second to fiberglass insulation. So that's it for us today. If you have some questions or maybe some feedback on how you've used mineral wool in your projects, we'd love to hear from you. And you can do that by dropping some comments below or visiting us at buildwithrise.com, your resource for sustainable home improvement. Thanks for tuning in, guys, and we'll catch you on the next one. Thanks so much for tuning in, guys. For more videos like this, don't forget to subscribe by clicking the button below, and also check out buildwithrise.com, the only place to turn any home improvement project into a sustainable one.